Hello everyone and welcome. I am Stendar and tonight we're on Roleplay Theory and we're going to do our first faction turn for our Stars Without Numbers campaign called the Daedalus Logs. We're joined by Casey Blake, who is the GM of this game. Casey, how are you doing tonight?
Very good. I'm the Space Master of Space.
Space Master of Space.
I'm excited.
The page we're on right now, this is Roll 20, and this is just a background I threw up to roll our dice on. We're not actually going to be doing very much other than dice rolling in Roll 20, and this just lets us see those dice. And Casey and me are both in this session, so he can roll dice, and I will be able to see it from my end. So that's just a good utility that we're going to use there. So, Casey, take us away.
The first thing I kind of wanted to talk about was one of my PCs, right off the bat, created a new clan, or a new faction.
Right.
They're going to be a minor faction. They're a group of smuggler gang members on the planet Alphdis, which is a Japanese...
It's in Priam.
Right, the rigid culture. Is that what it says?
Yep, secret masters, rigid culture, tech level 4, baseline protect, billions of inhabitants, hybrid biosphere.
Yes.
So, nice little.
So this Bandito clan is part of this secret overlord thing. The secret overlords.
Right.
They work with them. They're not a part of the government, but they work a lot with the Ichizo royal family. What we needed to do was give them some assets.
Let's do that. So, real quick. Might as well.
Let's real quick.
We kind of threw them together before this video. Let's go ahead and give them assets.
Go ahead, bring up the faction tracker and just show what we set them to. While I get this typed in real quick.
Sure. Bandito clan, scavengers, Alphdis, expand influence is their goal. We decided to make. So you decided to do cunning higher than force.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, cool. They're a minor faction with the potential to do other interesting things.
You got the hex map open?
I can very shortly. I set their relationship to NA.
It was negative. It's definitely negative.
Oh, is it negative?
No, they're definitely like my PCs.
Oh, that's right, because he's a
created a faction that already hates them.
Yeah. I have the sector map. What do you need?
I need to know what sector number Alphdis is in.
201.
201. That's
Priam.
Priam. P R I A M and A L F D I S. Correct.
A L F D I S. Alphdis.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep.
One of my PCs, one of my PCs used to be a member of this gang. And when he tried to, withdraw from the gang, they murdered his wife and tried to murder him, but he escaped. And now they wound up on this other planet where they ran into a member of that gang, and he was asking all these questions. And through this conversation where he's looking for this guy that murdered his wife so he can go and exact his revenge, that's sort of his character's long-term goal. When he actually goes and talks to then the other player characters about it, they start thinking, well, maybe we can become the smuggler group that works with this government if we overthrow this Bandito clan. And I'm just listening to my PCs talk about all this and going, you guys are awesome. So they're going to have a base of influence on Alphdis.
Yes.
And what other assets do they have?
Asset table. Now they have four 4 cunning and 3 force. So we need a cunning asset.
Okay, cool, that worked. All right.
I'm going to say they have stealth.
Well, now, if we'd have made them secretive, then all of their things would have stealth.
Right.
But you have to have a thing.
Oh, to justify.
They have covert shipping.
Nice.
Of course, they're a...
Allows for quiet transport of a unit from one world to another. Any one special forces unit can be moved between worlds within 3 hexes of covert shipping at the cost of 1 fac cred. Perfect.
Yeah, they definitely have covert shipping.
And then
they're
they
smugglers.
Need one force.
Mm-hmm.
Which they have a 3 force, so we can go all the way down to...
Hardened personnel.
Hardened personnel would be good.
I think hardened personnel is the way to go.
Yeah. Like, all I right. think hitmen would also be good, too.
Hardened personnel can't attack. They can only counterattack.
Right. I would do hitmen.
All right. Hitmen or elite skirmishers elite? Or security personnel or a militia unit. Alright, these are gang members, much like, I don't know, some horrible biker gang.
Like, let's do elite skirmishers. Are lightly equipped troops, they train for guerrilla warfare and quick raids. That sounds like these guys.
Yeah, that sounds perfect.
That sounds like these guys.
Elite skirmishers.
Okay, cool.
So let me copy and paste that in. All right, there we go. We've got them with their 3 assets, all of which are currently on Alphdis in Priam. I'm going to go ahead and put my... Oh, no, I can't. You have to do it.
I fixed your fill color. That's
a big deal. What was wrong with my fill color?
The base of influence was gray.
Oh, weird. Thank you. So, yeah, there's our new faction taken care of. They have assets... They have everything that they need. So January of the year 3200, my group gets together on Jala. What's the planet in Jala? Arnie. So they get together there. They take out their $1 million loan from the syncretic Protestant pagans. Because they're one of 4 factions that owned a bank. I let them decide what bank they went through, which then I used to determine what planet they started on.
Yeah, it was a cool way to kind of set up the...
Right, so I just explained to them what their characters would know about these 4 different banks in the sector. And one of them belongs to the syncretic Protestant pagans. They're a religious organization, and my players are under the impression... because of their background with people, that the syncretic Protestant pagans are going to have less violent thugs to come and kill them.
If they decide to default on their loan?
Which is sort of probably true.
See, I don't think so.
You don't think so?
Have you seen the syncretic Protestant pagans?
Well, you're not wrong.
Deep strike landers, hostile takeovers, pre-tech manufacturing. They have freaking space marines.
Yes, they have space marines.
They have space marines. If they want you dead, you're just dead.
So if we go over to the asset tracker, I'm going to organize these A to Z in there. All right, so there we go. The Edoni Neogen Alliance has a bank. They're a relatively peaceful faction so far.
Right, they're the only faction in the game with a fleet.
They have a capital fleet.
They have a capital fleet.
There's another one. You don't want to forfeit your loan against the people with the capital fleet.
No, you don't.
The Pelasgon Pippinger Band
right.
has a bank. They're the criminals that will totally kill you.
They'll totally kill you.
They're the drug dealers of the whole thing.
They're the most prone.
Right. Then there's the syncretic Protestant pagans, which, yeah, they have space marines, but whatever. Right. And then there's the Zahedi Combine, which we know...
Dehay and Bloodbats.
They're the horrible Bloodbat people that run the prison system.
And they'll kill you anyway, whether you pay them or not.
Right. They'll just eat your brain and blood and blood-brain barrier.
No, really everyone will kill you in this universe that we've created.
Yeah, no, you gotta work on your relationships with these people. So in January, all right, I think first let's talk about the relationship with the NPCs.
Okay.
So the syncretic Protestant pagans give them this loan and say, hey, we need you to fly down to Shuba and go to that planet where the Jiaoyin Corporation is. Get these robotic parts and bring them back. So they do this. They fly down there, get the robotic parts, fly them back. They spent the entire month of January
going those two X's?
Just to get to Shuba.
Oh,
they,
my goodness.
It took them 27 days to get to Shuba from Jala.
Two failed rolls on the navigation?
Yes. Then to get back took from the 27th of January to the 24th of February.
So the first 2 months of faction turns are them trying to get back and forth between Jala and Shuba?
Yes.
So their story is not very interesting.
There's 2 months of faction turns that literally at the table was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rolls, basically. I mean, we talked a little bit, but the actual gameplay mechanics that we engaged with were 6 rolls of navigating through sector jumps. At which point, all of my PCs looked at me like I had not paid them enough money for this job that took them 2 months that should have taken them just over a month.
Just over a month to fully get done?
Right. Six jumps should take a month and a half. It took them 2 months. So instead of having, you know, a few thousand dollars left over to start the next mission and then get paid again, they had to spend every bit of their savings or every bit of their pay for that job just not forfeiting on their loans.
Right.
Not forfeiting on their vehicle maintenance.
Right. To keep everything running and resupply and all of that.
Right. So they had decided immediately, all right, we have to get our navigator better at navigation as soon as possible. We have to get our spike drive upgraded as soon as possible because there's no way we are ever going to make any money at this rate.
Right.
So there's what happened in January
and
most of February.
Well,
so there's two faction turns.
Let's
do it. We'll start there. So if we look here at the faction tracker,
okay.
If you're playing this game at home, if you're using the same sheet that I'm using that you got from Adam Coble's and It Me JP's roleplay website, from 11 to 33 is the numbers that we want to land on.
Right.
So over here in roll 20,
we
are going to do / roll space 1d23 plus 10. So that accounts for the 10 slots at the top that are not factions.
Right. It'll be 11
through 33.
Right, because of the plus 10.
So, first faction. 13. I have these organized.
The Palazgon Pippinger Band.
Oh, they get to go first. That's so good. All right. So their goal is inside enemy territory.
Okay.
Which says, plan a number of stealth assets on worlds with other planetary governments equal to your cunning score. Units that are already stealthed on worlds when the skull is adopted do not count. Difficulty 2. So they want to try and move two units onto another planet that someone else controls. So, let's go look at the map. You got the map open?
I do.
Alright, you look at the map. I'm going to go to their asset tracker.
Okay.
What do we have?
Are we coming from Pelasgon? Because they have...
Right, alright. That's what I was about to say. Alright, we've got blockade runners on Kartik, or in Kartik.
Okay.
We've got the popular movement on Pelasgon. We've got a seductress on Kartik. And those are really the only things that are easy to move. They've also got a pre-tech manufacturing R&D department. So I think we're going to take the blockade runners.
Okay.
Okay. Blockade runners are smugglers. They excel at transporting goods through unfriendly lines. As an action, a blockade runner can transfer itself or any one military unit or special forces unit to a world within 3 hexes for a cost of 2 fact creds. So, do we want to take, because we could grab the if we take the blockade runners and the seductress.
Okay.
And go to any planet within 3 hexes.
Which
is a lot of them.
You could get anywhere in the galaxy, damn near.
Who? Not quite, but pretty close. Who I mean, do they want? Do they have any particular enemies right now? I don't think so.
No.
It makes sense for them to move into Madavi.
Madavi, Gaztain being a Gold Rush planet is just good business.
Ooh, all right. Obsidious. In the fiction, we haven't gotten to this part in how we're actually talking about the storyline, but right now, Huertas in Madavi, there's Huertas and Dynamine are the two planets there.
Yeah.
Right now, Huertas is very much anti Achilles Hector.
Right.
So I don't see any reason why they couldn't take their runners and their we can either take their
For those of you that don't remember, Achilles Hector is the drug that the Pelasgon Pippager Band manufacture.
Yeah. So yeah, I think we're going to take the seductress and the blockade runners.
Okay.
They're going to pay their 2 fact creds, so let's go do that.
Okay,
and
so
the faction tracker.
Faction tracker.
Oh, I need to actually pay them. All right, so the Pelasgon Pippager Band made 7.
Okay.
Then they paid 2, which lowers them down to 5.
Right.
To move their blockade runners. Do you have the sector map up?
They have a bank, and it says -1 per turn.
Right. That means, all right, normally, what do they own? They're basically what the bank does
is it negates a different cost.
Right. It negates 1 cost, exactly.
So, which they don't have anything to negate, so they're fine.
Right, exactly.
Okay. So, where are we moving them to?
So, Huertas.
Okay, so they're going to go to Huertas.
Right, what's that sector called?
That is in Madavi. It is 504, if you need that.
M-A-D-A-V-I?
M-A-D-H-A-V-I. Uh-huh. Madhavi.
Okay, and what was the sector number?
504.
504? Okay. Cool. So, we've got that. Copy.
So, Madavi's also our planet with our giant manta ray creatures, isn't it?
Correct.
Not Huertas. Huertas. Because they're xenophiles, correct, and they have flying cities.
Did I just screw that up? Pelasgon Pippager Band. Blockade Runners. No, 504 Madavi Huertas. All right. Copy, and then their Seductress is also there. Sorry about my dog scratching in the background.
It's okay. Mine was freaking out earlier.
Okay, so we've got the Seductress and the Blockade Runners both stealthed on another planet.
Okay.
Which means that their goal is met.
Okay. What does that mean?
Not expand influence. What's their goal?
Inside enemy territory.
Inside enemy territories. Plant a number of stealth assets on worlds with other planetary governments equal to your cunning score. Okay, what's their cunning score?
I was on the wrong page. Faction tracker, Plasgon, 8.
Okay, no, they're not even close yet.
Cool. Right.
So, since all they're doing is moving assets, and the Blockade Runners use their special ability,
They don't have to make a roll on that, do they?
I don't know. I don't think...
There's nothing in the Blockade Runners...
anything else right now.
Right, the Blockade Runners have a counterattack, but they don't have an attack, because it's not...
Right, no, they just moving assets. Their assets are stealthed. They don't want to attack. They don't want to cause any more trouble.
Right. When it comes time for... Does Huertas have a faction on it?
I don't think so.
So there won't be a faction there to try to uncover the stealth.
Like, we set up just sort of a...
Yeah, Huertas isn't on our list.
Yeah, it's a... I mean, they have a planetary government, but we didn't make a faction for them because I didn't think that it would be that important.
Right.
Do you want... I mean, we're still... It's turn one.
No. I don't want there to be one. I just wanted to know if there was...
Create a faction
for them? Well, I just wanted to know if there'd be someone there to roll to try to discover stealth.
No, right now, no.
So then, that's all I wanted to know.
There's no faction on this planet.
No, let the Plasgon Pippinger Band have their day. All right.
There should be, though. There should be someone here... I've already told the PCs that the planetary government is opposed to this
Achilles Hector stuff.
Achilles Hector. There needs to be another faction.
Maybe there will be.
All right, I'll work on that.
Well, it doesn't have to happen just yet.
I'll work on that when we're done with this. So, we paid them. We spent some money. We moved some assets. They're working towards their goal. That's it for them.
Okay.
So... All right, let's go back over to roll 20. Roll 1d23 plus 10, and we get
27.
Okay. Oh, yeah, I need to add another...
The Ishmali Protectorate.
I need another... Bam. And this is going to be the time... Whoops, let's not do that. And rename this. I added another tag. Tab. Protect sheet rename. That's what I want. Okay. So we got January. I need the faction tracker list.
Apparently the Zahidi Combine have a capital fleet? Why is that? Do they have a scavenger fleet? They have a scavenger fleet, not a capital fleet.
Does it say they have a capital fleet?
It says they have a capital fleet, but they don't. They have a scavenger fleet.
Why don't they have a capital fleet?
Because they have a scavenger fleet, because they have an 8 in cunning. They have an 8 in wealth, not in force. They can't.
Oh, yeah?
They can't have a capital fleet. So they must have a scavenger fleet.
Where did you see that?
You put it in the little tag over their wealth, their fact.
Oh, okay.
It just needs
right,
to be scavenger fleet.
It's right on the asset tracker.
Right. It just needs to.
I don't feel so bad about
no,
that.
No, it's just not right in my little comments.
Right.
Which I can fix that.
Scavenger fleets cost 2 fact creds per turn in maintenance.
Just like capital fleets.
Yes. Okay. So, in January, Why can't I delete this column? Cool, I did it.
All right. I'm doing all the math for all of your monies.
Oh, thank you.
So you're gonna lobby over there.
January of the year.
Okay, everybody's 32. Fat creds are correct.
What year is it? 3200?
Something like that.
I don't know.
I'll have to go back and watch our tutorial video to realize what
time. I've got it written down. It's in the textbook.
Once again, just so everyone knows, to get to this sheet, to get to the copy of the sector map or the creation thing, all of that is in the comments of the first tutorial video for when we were building this faction. So if you ever need to find those can be found on YouTube in that first tutorial video.
They move their blockade runners and seductress.
Correct. How interesting. So they're going to be screwing around. It makes sense that they moved to Mdavi. It's close by. Quick retreat if they need to. Let's go ahead and close both of these. I don't need that either. Oh, still don't need that. Onditz. Nagor. And Lamella.
Okay, so they
world.
Move their blockade runners and their seductress to Huertas.
Okay. So now we have...
Yeah, what did I
the
roll?
The Ismaili Protectorate.
Okay, the Ismaili Protectorate.
They are Preceptor currently. Archive. Ismaili. Yep. Wealth of Worlds is their goal.
And what does that mean?
Oh, allow me.
No, I've got it. Spend fact creds equal to four times your faction's wealth rating on bribes and influence. This money is effectively lost, but the goal is then considered accomplished. The faction's wealth rating must increase before this goal can be selected again. Cool.
Interesting. So what does that mean for their start?
So,
they have a wealth of one.
The Ismaili Protectorate
has a wealth
they
of.
They currently have two fact creds.
They could just spend both their fact creds. Because that's twice as much, correct? Or is it twice or four times?
It was twice. I'll read it again. Spend
four
fact
times.
Creds. Oh, equal to four times your
so
fraction's
worth. Next turn, they could double their money.
And influence.
And
yep.
Do it. So this turn, I think they sit on their hands.
Well, they can do other things. Let me look at their assets.
Okay. I'll come with you.
The Ismaili Protectorate. They have covert shipping.
Correct.
And post-tech infantry.
Correct.
All right. And the Ismaili Protectorate, that's the one out there in the middle of nowhere on Shaina. I think... Who are they going to bribe? Who do they want influence with?
Well, they are in Anitza? What's there?
Shaina, 401.
Shaina. Oh, yes, they have the archive, and they're very secretive about it.
I think maybe... Based on where they're at, they want some influence with Spiker.
Okay.
If I was going to guess. They want to, I think they're going to try, maybe their goal inside this goal is to make a deal with Spiker so that all of his exports will go through their sector.
And to give them wealth.
And they'll get to make money off of the ships, stopping for repairs, stopping for refueling. So cool.
Okay, cool.
So they're just going to straight up give two credits to Spiker right off the bat. So Spiker Multistellar then makes...
Do they have to spend it in one turn? Or is it...
Nope.
Okay, nope. So cool. They can do that then.
I put their current fact creds down to zero.
Yes.
I put Spiker's fact creds up to seven.
Right, because he loses two at the beginning.
Right. Then on their goal... of Wealth of Worlds,
Nice. They got
I'm
two.
Going to say that, yeah, they're 2 out of 4.
This is the best Excel spreadsheet in the entire universe.
I know. It's so good. I don't know who made this for Adam, but it
I love
is
you.
So good.
I love you. Like, in a deep way. I want you to know that.
2 out of 4. No.
Wealth of Worlds. Cool.
Did I screw that up somewhere?
2 out of 4. You're fine. You didn't miss. Because Peaceable Kingdom right above it has the same kind of deal.
Right.
Is it supposed to?
Okay. Yeah, Peaceable Kingdom is don't attack anyone for 4 turns.
Oh, nice.
You can defend, you just can't attack.
The one above it should also then have it.
Yeah, I just haven't made the note. So yeah, I don't know that the Ismali Protectorate is gonna do anything else.
I put the note in, it's okay.
Are they gonna... Alright, they... I'm going to put on the timeline that they pay for. Does that look okay? Pay for influence and spiker shipping deals?
Where'd you put that?
On the timeline.
Oh, we have a timeline.
Yeah.
I didn't even realize we had a timeline. Hello, pretty timeline. Yes, paid for influence with Spiker shipping deals.
Cool.
Wow. I'm all excited about this timeline.
I know. It's going to be something to...
No, eventually.
Know. It's going to be something to sit down with my players tomorrow and try and explain what's happened in the last 6 months.
Right, because that's all they get to see is the timeline.
Right. Well, they don't even get to see everything in the timeline. I have to work it into some way that they would actually find this stuff out.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
Okay, cool. Roll us some more dice. Because they're done. It's more like it's done.
They spent money. They got their income and immediately spent it.
Yeah.
Do asset tracker real quick. Let me double check. Covert shipping, post-tick infantry. Yeah, that's all they can do.
Because based on their goal, they have no need for any of the other things.
Right. They could move something somewhere, but I don't know that that's really important right now for them.
Does that greatly help them in any way, really?
No. We'll find out next month.
Tune in next time.
So, roll 1d23 plus 10, and we get 17.
Which just so happens to be the syncretic Protestant pagans.
Okay.
With their 8 faction creds. They are fanatical.
17.
Expand influence.
Yes.
Plant a base of influence on a new planet. Difficulty 1, plus 1 if the attempt is contested by a rival faction.
Yes, so they have, right now, we'll just talk about what they have.
Okay.
They are the planetary government on the only planet in Jala.
Right, so win.
Whoops, go away.
In Madari, they have a settlement on Tho.
Uh-huh, and they have another settlement...
On Synassus.
In Gastang. So, we can look at Shadia... Which is in Gastain. That's the planet.
That's the Gold Rush planet.
That's the Gold Rush planet.
And that's definitely where I would put it if I was Jala. If I was, you know, the...
Are you sure? No, they don't have anything on Tho.
If I was...
They have something on Sandia.
They have a... Oh. Tho...
It's in the same sector.
Ah, yes. Sandia is the Outpost world. My bad. For some reason, I thought the other one was the... Amaviska Brotherhood, but that's in Orsala.
Tho is my tech level 4 planet that there's currently a civil war going on between the two human factions, the West Solidarity and the
Victory.
Victory, yeah, that
Victory
one.
Victory folks.
So,
Victory
do you think
Union.
They're more interested in putting a base of influence on the civil war planet? Or on the Gold Rush planet?
Well, if they can end the Civil War and gather all that military power.
Right.
And absorb West Solidarity, and the Victory Union. That could be a lot of power for them.
I don't think they want to move up into Arisali right now. That's where the Area 51 planet is.
Right, and that's the Amaviska.
Both planets in Adoni are already under control by another Hegemon.
Right, the Adoni. They don't want to dance with the...
Right, they don't want to pick that fight just yet.
Right, with the Adoni Neo Gen Alliance, that's... They don't want to... Yeah, they don't want to do that. I don't think. I wouldn't. Not at turn one.
So, do they go in to play with major factions that are already fighting with each other?
They're both minor factions.
Oh, they're both minor factions?
Yeah,
okay.
No, they go to West. They go to, though, they're going to try to absorb these two minor factions to get access to West Solidarity's Cyber Ninjas and their strike fleet. They want that. And then, you know, your Victory Union, they have a monopoly on something. I don't know what they have a monopoly on. And they have their security personnel, which is not as good. I think the West Solidarity is going to win. Either way, they have good things that if the SPP can absorb them, they'll get all of these wonderful assets, which will definitely give them a boost. So, if I was playing as the Pagans, I would definitely want to move in on this very much controlled asset that I have nearby here.
I'm looking at... Alright, so Gaztain...
Yes.
On Shadia. Yes. No, Shadia in Gaztain. That's where their Space Marines currently are.
The Gold Rush planet?
They also, they have organization moles on Sandia, which is in the same sector, right?
Yes.
So yeah, I think they're going to take their organization moles.
And try to set up an outpost?
And, like, the organization moles don't set up an outpost. They come and join your military and are, you know, right there alongside you.
They're new guys.
So they definitely are going to move their org moles to Tho.
And that will give them a base of influence on that planet.
Yeah. So. Who's
it's going to be difficulty 2.
Moved org moles to Tho.
So now, what's this difficulty 1, difficulty 2 thing mean?
It determines how much experience points you get for doing it.
Ah.
And then as you gain experience, as your factions gain experience points, they get to up their wealth, force, and cunning.
Cool.
Abilities. So.
Timeline. Moved org moles to Tho.
Yep. And they didn't even have to jump sector. They're already in sector.
Right.
I don't know. Like, the org moles aren't stealthed, but they subvert and confuse enemy assets, striking to damage their cohesion. So, which... I think the org moles are just there. They're going to wait and see what happens.
Right.
So they moved, they can't attack this turn anyway, they just got on planet, right. So that's it for them.
Okay.
They got paid. Did they have to pay 1 to move them on world? I think so. I think they had to pay 1 fact cred
to
move them on world. So they go down from 8 to 7. Why did they have 8?
They get +1 from the party machine.
Okay, fair enough.
That's what it says in the note. I'm just doing what the note tells me. No, they're going to be rich. So freaking rich.
Yeah,
it's going to be almost disgusting.
They're going to be real strong real soon.
Real strong, real fast.
So yeah, they moved their unit in sector to another planet. I think that's all they can do this turn.
Okay.
I'm going to say they still don't have a relationship with the PCs, even though the PCs have their loan from them and have done one job for them. I don't think that's enough to get their relationship status boosted, but I think it's beginning. I guess they do know who the PCs are, at least. So maybe they're just going to be decent. I don't know. That's dissent. Decent. Ooh, maybe decent isn't a good word if you can't spell it, dummy. Are they friendly? Like, they're not a trusted ally, but I think they're friendly.
I'm friendly is good enough. As friendly as your bank is.
As friendly as your green.
Because they're friendly. That's green.
Right?
Put hostile in one.
Ah. I didn't know if it was. No, it's not hostile.
Enemy?
I can't even spell enemy right. Nope. I don't know what the keyword is to change the color on that.
Interesting. Well, friendly's definitely a good thing.
I'm going to figure it out, though.
Yeah, we'll get that.
Not right now. Not important right now.
We're gonna sunrise that. We're going to wait on that one. We'll figure out how we get that one next time.
So, can we roll again?
Yeah, man.
Okay. Did we miss anything?
No.
All right.
Let's roll on the next one.
16. Looks like the Adoni Neogen Alliance.
Man, we're getting all the hedgemongs out.
Pay 2 to the Capital Fleet. Pay 1 to the Pre-Tech Researchers.
And they got a bank.
I spelled that wrong.
There's a V in there.
The V and the C are right next to each other. I just fat fingered it. So their total is pay 2. Cool. Deep-rooted and expand influence. So where are they going to try and expand their influence?
Well, if I was them, because...
Because they've got those two planets.
Let's go and asset tracker.
They've got an outpost on...
they have base of influence on...
On Diogenes.
That they have a base of influence on Dynamine, on Mosdeg, and on Tornikiotis. So, which is Anitza and Adonia.
It shouldn't be Dynamine.
It is Dynamine on here. What is it supposed to be?
All right, well, you fix that. It's Diogenes. Does it say Grid 505?
Yes.
And it says Ain't Zane.
Ain't Zane. Diogenes.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah, Dynamine's up in the top left. I don't know why that was.
I just wrote that instead of Diogenes.
Because
that's okay.
It's okay. It's all good. So so they have influence on Ain't Zane and Adoni. So if I were them, I would definitely want to close the gap and get some influence on
Actoris.
I was going to say Lacerates.
Lacerates. Yeah. But that's in Actoris is what I meant. That's the monk planet with the sealed menace. Oh, you did know that? Oh, good. Okay, so let's go over to the Adoni Protectorate.
Sealed menace planet.
On the asset tracker. Adoni Neogen Alliance. They have a capital fleet. They have pre-tech infantry.
Planetary defenses.
Pre-tech
logistics. Pre-tech manufacturing. Pre-tech researchers. And a transit web.
Oh, they did get a transit web, didn't they? That's awesome.
So they can move anything for one.
Yeah, I know, right? So, do they want to do that, or do they want to activate?
I would put their pre-tech researchers over there, because they want to research the planet and the weird readings they've been getting from it.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Are they sending their infantry with them?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
two fat crits.
Oh, we moved Orgmul's to Tho. That's all we did, yeah. Okay. Yeah, go ahead and pay there. No, it's only one fact trade.
Any number? Is that what it said? Any number?
On the asset tracker. Transit web.
I'll really
any number
all
of
assets. Yeah, that's full. For one fat cred, any number of non-starship cunning or wealth assets.
And does not require the use of an action. So they still get to do an action top of that.
Pre-tech infantry is a force.
Oh, cunning or wealth. Okay.
So cunning, pre-tech research is cunning, I believe. Or wealth, could be either one, I'm not sure. Let me jump back to the asset table real quick. Pre-tech infantry is a force asset. Pre-tech researchers is a wealth asset. So that's fine. We can move them, no big deal.
So
then I would just send the researchers.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very peaceful. We're just coming to see the monks. And we're going to do some research. No big deal. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain.
Don't need neogenolines. Moved. Pre-tech researchers. What's the name of that planet? Ooh. Lycerides, L-Y-S.
S-A-R-I. D-E-S.
To study.
Strange readings.
Monks.
Wonderful. So, what else do they want to do?
They're going to activate the special ability on their pre-tech manufacturing.
Which is,
as an action, the owning faction may roll 1d8 and gain half of that many fact creds rounded up.
Oh my gosh.
So
sweet, we could actually see a dice roll.
We're going to roll 1d8. Oh. I got an 8.
So you get 4 fact creds.
So they get to make $4.
$4 bill.
Adoni Neogen Alliance goes up to 9. Currently the wealthiest
of all the space lords.
That's not what I wanted to do.
That is ridiculously powerful.
It's real good.
Oh my gosh. I'm so excited because when we built these, you know, I didn't really get a feel, you know, how balanced we made any of them.
Right, no, we were just guessing. It's
we
our
were
first
just
time.
Guessing, first time ever doing this, so getting to see what happens now and see who gets in the lead real fast is going to be really interesting.
And they activated, what's the name of that thing? Pre-tech.
Manufacturing.
Four credits. Why can't I put... Can you put a space, or not a space, but a enter, return after monks?
Oh.
Because mine just keeps moving down to the next box.
And the timeline... Oh, what are you needing?
After monks, on move pre-tech researchers to Lycerides to study the monks, go to there and put in, hit enter. I just want it to go down a line and stop. I'm sure.
Control enter.
Control enter?
Yes. What'd you do? Cool. How did you break it? I fixed it. Put your little cursor in front of activate, okay? And put control enter.
It's fixed on my screen. Oh, now it just went back.
There you go.
Okay, cool.
Activate pre-tech.
And we gave him their $9. They're up to 9 credits. Everything's good. They don't care about the PCs. They're trying to expand their influence. I think they're fine.
Sure.
Cool.
I ain't got no problem with that.
All right. 1d23 plus 10.
Oop, my bad. What was it? 32.
I rolled a 32.
That'll be our final. That is nothing. I don't. That's way too high.
What?
Well, it
shouldn't be.
It is, though, because you rolled a 22. Your plus 10 only works if it rolls below.
What did I roll? A 32?
Yeah, I mean, what did you
It's the Victory Union. You're on the wrong screen. Go to the faction tracker.
Whoa, my bad.
Nah, that'll
Victory
fix you there.
Victory Union.
All right, their goal is Invincible Valor.
Which, if we go to goals and reads,
destroy a force asset with a minimum purchase rating higher than your faction's force rating.
This would be our first combat roll, then.
So what's their force rating? Their force rating is 1.
Right.
So they're on Tho with the West Solidarity.
Right, so if I go to West Solidarity in the
on
asset
the asset
tracker,
tracker,
they have cyber ninjas and a strike fleet.
Are cyber ninjas? Why is that invalid content?
Cyber ninjas have a cost of 4, which is fine. They also have a no counterattack. So it's honestly a free shot, you know what I'm saying?
Our cyber ninjas are cunning.
Oh, they're not a force asset.
Right? Do they don't own a force.
Is
Strike Fleet
a force
4. Asset? On a force asset?
It's a cost. It's not cost, it's the TL, right? The tech level?
Yeah. No.
Is it the cost or the tech level?
Let me look at their goal again.
Yeah, read it.
Minimum purchase rating. The purchase rating.
So the force, okay, a force level 4 then. It's a level 4 item,
okay.
But it has a 1d8 counterattack.
I know. What do they have to attack it with?
Nothing.
The Victory Union? No, they can attack with their monopoly.
Wealth versus wealth.
Or they can attack with their
security personnel. They're 1d3 plus 1.
Terrible. So I think they're going to attack with their monopoly. Like, that makes sense.
But it's only wealth and wealth.
But that's fine. Well, I'll show you how it works.
Okay, please do.
I know you don't know. I know you don't know.
I have
know
no
how it
idea.
Works,
right? This is WVW. You can't do that. It's not WVF.
Right. So the Victory Union's wealth is 4. The West Solidarity's wealth is 1. So we're going to do, if you go over to the roll 20.
Yeah.
Okay, this is, actually, I'm going to write it in the timeline real quick.
Okay, let's go look at that.
On the Victory Union. That's whose turn we're doing right now.
Yes, sir.
They're going to attack the West Solidarity Strike Fleet with Monopoly. Oops.
What are you doing here?
Now, if we go to roll 20, we're gonna roll, it's wealth versus wealth, so 1d10 plus 4. All right, and that gets me a 10.
Okay.
And then the other, the defense is going to be 1d10 plus 1 because they only have a 1 wealth.
Okay, so they're attacking the other turn
and it's a critical fail.
Yeah, that's a one.
So, we've got success. And it deals, how much damage does the Monopoly deal? The Monopoly deals 1d6, no. Yeah, 1d6 damage to their strike fleet. So, in roll 20, we're going to roll 1d6. Deal 6 damage. Wow.
And how much health does the strike fleet have?
I don't know yet. I'm about to go find out.
Is it in the book?
No, it should say right there on the asset tracker.
Okay.
So the West Solidarity Strike Fleet has 12 hit points, so it goes down to 6. That sucks.
That's a hit.
And they don't get to counterattack.
They don't have 12 hit points. They have 12 cost. They have 8 hit points. HP cost, tech level.
Oh, really? So it's backwards on this other spreadsheet.
Do what now?
Well, if you go to the asset table.
Yeah, the asset tables. It's
HP cost, tech level.
Okay.
Go to the asset tracker. It's not HP first. So this needs to be HP.
It's completely, it's just weird.
Cost. And then max HP needs to actually
be tech level. They're correct, though.
What do you mean?
Well, hold on, let me...
Okay, it can't
where,
be.
Where is it? Okay, no, I'm right. You're right. 8 and 12. Yeah, so those were backwards for some reason.
Yeah.
So yes, they only have 8 health in that, so that goes down to 2.
Thank you, sir.
Wow. That was a good move
for
the Victory Union.
That sucks.
That was a good move for the Victory Union.
And you said the Victory Union didn't stand a chance.
I did. They're a bunch of bankers and top hat wearers.
I know. They're the oligarchy.
Yeah, but I mean the cyber ninjas might just come kill them all next turn.
Fear the oligarchy. All right. So they attacked. That's all they can do. They haven't achieved their goal, but they're really close to it.
They're moving on it.
And that's awesome.
Cool.
So I'm going to roll the 1d23 plus 10.
And that puts us...
28.
Action tracker. That puts us at the Thalians, which is interesting because we are currently on that planet.
Actually, we're not actually there for another
right.
4 months.
4 months, but right now we're in deep space. But when last I was sitting at the table watching, we made it to that place.
And they're trying to destroy the Sandus. So. Yes.
They're both at war with one another. Destroy your foe, which just comes right out to destroy a rival faction. Until they beat the other person, their goal is not completed.
So, what's the Sandus' wealth, force, and cunning scores?
The Sandus are 4-3-1, and the Thalians are also 4-3-1.
Okay, so it's all going to be equal.
Yeah, they right are now. Perfectly matched at the moment.
Okay, so are they going to attack with their cyber ninjas?
They also have cyber ninjas.
Or
they?
Their post-tech infantry? I actually think that they can attack with both, based on what I read in the book. I'm going to read it to you.
Okay.
And you tell me if it sounds the same.
Okay.
Let me go to it. Sorry. This is on page 114. Attacking is the chief way by which a faction assaults a rival's assets and organizational structure. A successful attack can damage or destroy an enemy asset or the leadership and cohesion of an enemy faction. Attacks can only be launched against known assets. Stealth assets are not available. They cannot be targeted for an attack until they've been discovered. To launch an attack, the attacker selects one or more of their own assets and targets a rival faction with assets on the same world. One at a time, each attacking asset is matched against a defending asset chosen by the defender. Each attacking asset can attack only once per turn, though a defending asset can defend as many times as the defender wishes, assuming it can survive multiple conflicts. So yeah, they're going to use both their cyber ninjas and their post-tech infantry to attack. It's like Magic the Gathering. They're going to attack the base of influence, but then the Sandus say, I'm going to defend. With their saboteurs or their zealots?
Yeah, they're zealots.
They're definitely going to defend with their zealots.
Yeah.
Zealots only have 4 hit points, though, which sucks for them. So, which first? The cyber ninjas first? Cunning versus cunning? What are their cunning ratings? Both 4?
Yeah, they're both 4. No, both 3. It's 4,
they're both
cunning,
3.
12.
So, over in roll 20, you've got 1d10 plus 3. Oof. 1d10 plus 3. Alright, so that's a successful attack. No counterattack. So in the timeline, we got the Thalians. Ah! Jeez. Sorry. Big old cricket crawled up on my armrest of my chair. I thought it was a spider. Thalians are going to attack the Sandus with their cyber ninjas. It's a success. Roll 2d6 for me. See how much damage these cyber ninjas do.
Alright.
Yeah, that's some dead. I'm really dead. Sandu zealots.
The zealots have 4 health.
Yeah, no, they're real dead. That's what I said.
Is that asset destroyed?
That asset no longer exists. So I'm deleting it. I'm deleting the row.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah,
I don't think the bird people are going to win, brother.
Like, that's the beauty of going first. You know what I mean? So now the post-tech infantry are going to attack.
Did they not get a counterattack with the zealots?
No, the counterattack is what you do if the force v force goes in your favor, or it's a tie. In the case of a tie, sometimes they both get to go, sometimes neither of them get to go. It depends on some outlying factors.
What's next?
So now the post-tech infantry are going to attack the Sandus.
The saboteurs.
And they're going to, defend with their saboteurs.
Okay.
So, what are their 4 scores?
Let me go over to the faction tracker. 4 on both.
Okay.
So we have
that's a 1.
Critical fail.
And a 3. So, now...
Who rolled first?
The attacking always rolls first. So, the Thalians roll first. They fail to attack successfully. The Sandus defend with their saboteurs. But have no counterattack, and thus nothing happens.
Okay.
So, in the timeline... bigger, do my control enter. They attack the Sandus with their post tech, right? It's post tech infantry?
Yes, post tech.
Failed. No. Yeah, that sucks.
Wow. I was really actually rooting for the bird people.
Some assets are better than others.
No kidding.
Okay. We already paid them their money, and they attacked with everything they can attack with, and I think that's all.
Let me check the Yes, there's the timeline. Failed, no counter. All right. Well, that brings us to 1 hour and 5. So we're going to end the first episode right there. We still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 factions to do. That is part one of faction turn one. So thank you for joining us. Like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and we'll catch you guys on the next episode.
We'll be right back.
Right back.